All right, so let's talk about Apollo.io in terms of. Okay, cool. Let's talk about Apollo.io in terms of email personalization. Okay, so this is a hot topic for everybody, obviously. So if I wanted to personalize an email in Apollo, right, and it was a sequenced email, right? Obviously, if it's a one-off, we can just go about our business and you know, type our personalization, send it out, all good. But what if I wanted to make that a template or a continuously used kind of field, right? So for this, I always recommend to clients using a dynamic field, right? Just like we have first name here and company name, we can use a dynamic field for personalization, but let's talk about what that would look like, right? So if I'm going to come back here and just check out this idea, right? So this is my version of using Apollo for a personalized email. We're going to get into this AI assistant in a little bit. Unfortunately, I don't think that they're quite ready to have like a ton of scale and volume go through that method, but this is still a pretty easy way for us to get through it. So in terms of personalization, right, you can see here that I've created a personalization insert here, right? So how does that get there, right? It gets there by us coming to our configurations over to contacts, going to custom fields, and then we can look here for, and there's a lot, but we can look here for personalization. Now, what does this look like in practice, right? Let's just take a single example and we'll use my profile for this. So if I were to come over to Michael Falco and let's just say I wanted to personalize an email to me, right? Now, let's just say I really like to hone in on education, right? So a really nice way to do this would be to come over to the contact side, right? I would go to custom fields. We could actually pull me up here. Cool. We could see me here. We're going to go ahead and save me. And then if we come over to the saved portion here and go into my profile, we can see pretty simply that we can insert our personalization, right into this field. So let's just say we're using this as a test. Go Villanova Wildcats, right? Easy enough. Okay, cool. So we're going to go ahead and save that, right? Now, if we were to put me into a sequence here, right? And let's just go ahead and give that a shot. So if I were to put me in a sequence and I were to say, we're going to add it to the sequence with the manual outreach. We're going to just see that this very simply is able to transfer over that information, right, over to our manual outreach here. So if I were to look at the emails that are queued up here, right, and go to drafted, and then go to, let's just try this. Yep. Okay. So you could see here that even though I haven't written anything, right, you could see that our personalization field auto-populated here. So if I were an SDR or a team working on outbound right now, right, I would focus on setting this as a bucketed or a bulked task, right? Take all of your prospects, put them in a list, run through that list in terms of what personalization you need to pull, right? Now, this could come from LinkedIn. It can come from their Twitter, their Facebook, their Instagram, their GitHub, whatever it may be, right? But this does give you a way of saying, hey, instead of me sitting there and typing in messages each time, this gives you a little bit more of a tabular kind of focus and allows you to do, you know, all of your work kind of in the same bucket. I always talk about that with my teams, right? So aside from that, right, if you're working with CSVs outside of Apollo, this also helps out a lot. And I'll just show you really quickly why. So you can see here, if you're working in a CSV, you can also include the personalization within one of these columns. And then when we run our import, we can map it directly. Okay, cool. Gonna pause there. Thanks for watching. Appreciate it.